Hi, my name is Carrie Berglund, and I am the Director of Education at Digitalis Education Solutions. I'm here to talk to you about our Universal Console interface. The Universal Console is a web-based interface that enables you to control your Digitarium digital planetarium system over a wired or wireless network. You can run it on a desktop computer or an iPad. I will be using an iPad in this video today. The Universal Console does not replace our backlit handheld remote control. In fact, you can use both interfaces during the same presentation if you wish. Both the Universal Console and the remote control are specifically designed to make it simple to do live, scripted, and pre-recorded video presentations. The Universal Console has all of the functionality of the remote control and a whole lot more. For example, the Universal Console hides absolutely any trace of the user interface from your audience, maximizing the immersive experience. Run a software script, change your latitude or longitude, show images or video, and more, all without displaying a single line of text on the dome. The Universal Console functionality is split into several different screens, and each screen is accessed via a tab along the top here. I will briefly cover the functions on each screen. At the far left-hand side is the Observer tab. The Observer tab allows you to set your viewpoint and your simulation time. Along the left side of this screen are location settings, latitude, longitude, heading, etc. There are inertial sliders for adjusting these, or you can enter exact numbers with the on-screen keyboard. On the right half of the Observer page are the simulation time settings. There's a calendar for simply choosing a date, or you can input an exact date with the keyboard. There are also buttons like a DVD remote control for simply fast-forwarding time, rewinding, etc. At the bottom of every screen is a Universal Console logo. This logo allows you to fast forward, rewind, or go back to real time on every page, so you don't need to move back to the Observer page to control time. The Objects screen allows you to display labels for various objects, such as stars, deep space objects, constellations, planets, moons, and more. From this screen, I can zoom in or out on any object, show constellation line drawings and artwork, and change my constellations to a different culture. I can also sort, filter, and search for objects. The Script screen allows me to select and run software scripts. These scripts can be local, on a USB drive, or on the internal hard drive. I can scroll up and down in the list as needed to find the appropriate script. To select a script, I just tap its name. If the script file has comments, the comments are displayed here. If I want to pause a script, restart it, etc., I can do that using these playback buttons at the bottom of the screen. If I am playing a script with a soundtrack, this slider gives me volume control. Moving to the right, the next tab is the Media screen for displaying images and videos or playing audio tracks. As with the Script screen, my files show up in a tree along the left-hand side, and I can scroll as needed. When I select a folder, the files within that folder show up as thumbnails along the top of the screen. Video files have film strips on the sides to distinguish them from images. Tapping the thumbnail once shows me the file name so I can confirm I've chosen the correct file. Tapping it a second time places it on the dome. If it's a movie file, it will start playing. Along the right side of the media screen, I have several display controls, including mirroring the image or video, showing the image over the entire dome or just a portion, adding slots for displaying different media at the same time, etc. With my fingers, I can move files around the dome, scale them up or down, and rotate them in real time. Along the bottom of the media screen, I have video and soundtrack controls. For example, I can pause a video, play a background audio track, play a slideshow of images, and control volume with a slider. The next tab is the References screen. This allows me to turn various reference lines, grids, markers, etc. on and off. I simply tap on the name of the reference to turn it on or off. The next tab is Settings. This enables you to change configuration settings, such as the language for the user interface itself, or object labels, the limiting magnitude of projected stars, light pollution simulation settings, change the colors of lines or other markers, and more. This tab at the far right will only appear if your fixed dome has Bowen Technovations AstroFX Aurora Cove lights. Our dome does, and this lights screen allows us to control the cove lights without having to use a separate interface. I can adjust the red, green, blue values individually, run any of 16 different preset programs, or simply fade the lights up and down from this light screen. The Universal Console interface software is included with all fixed-dome Digitarium system purchases. It is available as an optional add-on for portable Digitarium systems. Most customers who bought a Digitarium system before the launch of the Universal Console can purchase the interface software as an upgrade. To get the Universal Console, you will just need to update your Digitarium system, which is an easy automated process. Contact us to purchase this upgrade and to confirm whether or not your existing Digitarium hardware will support it. In summary, the Universal Console gives me all of the functionality of Digitalis's remote control and a whole lot more. By running the Universal Console on an iPad, I maintain the ability to move around the dome and teach from anywhere.